So, yeah. So we'll move on from there. Let's go on and discuss JT Daniels entering the transfer portal. He is obviously a massive recruit that USC got before this past season. He played in the 2018 season and then got injured in the first game in the 2019 season. And, you know, you would think that he'd be able to come back and compete for his job. Obviously, Keaton Slovis was a fantastic quarterback last year, threw for 30 touchdowns, like almost 3,500 yards. Now, a lot of that had to do with the type of offense that they were running because they brought in Graham Harrell from North Texas. Everybody seemed to believe that he was going to stay for another year and he was going to compete for the job. But the issue is he has ended up going to, good gracious, everybody's saying that we're having bad connections today. Is what it is, I guess. Keaton Slovis basically won that job last year. And it's going to take a lot for JT Daniels to come in after not having played in Graham Harrell's system for an entire season and be able to win the job. Now, Keaton Slovis had his issues as well, but I think that JT Daniels, had he stayed, would have had a good enough shot to be able to win that job at USC. And we got, we got Chris back in. We got your audio.
Yeah, I don't know what the hell happened, man.
Man, it's technology. Michael actually jumped in and said the connection has been pretty bad on my end as well. So maybe we're just having internet problems today or just technology. Well,
my computer shut down, so that's...
Yeah, no, that's a different deal.
Completely restarted.
That's a whole different deal. So Matt jumped in and said NCAA cannot get that money. And I don't know if that's in reference to the basketball or if it's not. Matt said your computer's got the Rona. So... it may do it. It may do it. So, maybe. All right. So what I'm talking about, I moved on to JT Daniels entering the transfer portal from USC. This is basically in prep of, Hudson jumped in. JT is really in the transfer portal. Wow. Now, I think we all kind of thought that he might jump in early.
Yeah. We had too many quarterbacks at USC that got to play.
Yeah.
And showcased their talent last year. And while it was nice to see, man, they're loaded at quarterback. Every time they throw a new guy out there, the team really doesn't struggle or get worse, which that is a credit to Clay Helton. But well, also,
and Graham Harrell. I mean, it's a lot of Graham Harrell. That's okay, his offense. All right,
you got to give the head coach some credit as well.
Yeah, no. I'm not giving him credit.
But here's the issue. Now other schools are like, hey, you want to ride the pine? Because we got a starting spot. And I totally understand and respect some of these kids are going to leave.
Oh, yeah. Now here's the deal. He could stay at USC, and there are a lot of people that believe that he will. From what has been reported, et cetera, this is in preparation of the NCAA voting on the one-time exemption for transferring without having to sit out. So if he can go to another school and not have to sit out a year, and a lot of these guys can come up with reasons for them to not have to sit out anyway. Obviously, the kid down at Miami, Justin Fields at Ohio State, et cetera. Like, you find reasons, right? We've talked about this in the past. But with this, he was like, I don't have to even come up with a reason. Like, I can go on and enter the transfer portal, and, you know, rather than try and battle Keaton Slovis, who had an entire season in Graham Harrell's offense,
that's right.
I wouldn't have to deal with that. I can just go somewhere new and start immediately. And that wouldn't be that big of a problem. Now, the issue is, where are you going to go, you know, with all these issues with COVID-19, with schools not being open, et cetera, like it could be a little bit of an issue to get into a new school and learn the playbook and figure everything out, right? Like that, it could be a
slight
issue.
Well, he would be just like any incoming freshman. The difference is you know he's got the talent.
Yeah, he was a five-star. He graduated early, came in.
He's more proven and more experienced than most schools bringing in an incoming freshman.
Yes. If you don't
have a quarterback, it's no different than him having to learn the playbook. Everybody's going to be on the same playing field when it comes to that. If you got a new coach this year, new offensive coordinator this year, or you lost your quarterback and you're bringing in a new quarterback, they're all going to have the same problems. Everybody's going to have this world. If we get football at all, they're all going to have the same learning curve.
Yeah. Yeah. You got that right.
So I don't fault the kid, and I don't blame him. And that there's lots of opportunities for him to go find a place to play.
Yeah.
He's better than a whole lot of quarterbacks out there.
Now, where he would go, I have no idea. Michael jumped in and asked that. Any ideas where he would go? At this point?
At this point, no. No clue.
Yeah, I got no idea. I mean, no.
At some point in time, we could maybe look back and see who recruited him originally and where are those coaches and what is their quarterback situation. Because obviously he either liked the school or liked the coach that was there. And you can kind of start speculating those things. But that's as far as the speculation can go.
Yeah.
Right now.
I would say that he would want to stay West Coast. Obviously, he went to school out in Santa Ana, California. I would think he would want to stay West Coast, but I mean,
that's all speculation. East Coast, I mean, it's all speculation.
Yeah, at this point there's no idea.
You're only guessing that because he grew up in California and he went to a California school. That's our only logic, and that's good logic. I mean, I'd follow that. I'd probably agree with that. But if for some reason, you know, he had South Carolina as one of the schools that he was, you know, considering going to over USC, then do we know that, you know, that has anything to do with it? I don't know.
Let's see. Mike Leach offered him first. Then USC offered him the next day. Michigan offered him.
Colorado offered him. I'm not worried about people offering him. Are these places that he was interested in going to?
So these were just the offers that he had back in 2016, 2017. Now, as far as where he was interested in going, obviously 247, like once you're done, then, you know, they don't worry about it anymore. But this is where, like, he had offers from Alabama, Colorado. Like, I could maybe see him going to Michigan. I mean, I could see that. Michigan, you know, they've got one of the McCaffrey kids, but.
So my first thought was Colorado, knowing that he's a California kid.
Yeah.
You know, it's not the West Coast, but it's, you know.
It's close. It's
very
close.
Similar in lifestyle outside of warm weather and beaches, but very laid back, laxed state. And new coach, new organization coming in there. I could easily see that.
Stanford offered him as well. So, you know, he could do Stanford. He could do LSU offered him in 2017.
The difference between like Stanford and USC, offensively speaking, though, is do you want to go run that offense?
Yeah.
You'd be the greatest quarterback in the world, man, but they're going to handcuff you.
100%.
I mean, you're going to hand the ball off a whole lot. You're going to run a lot of I formation.
And he may do that at Colorado, too. I mean,
all this crazy fun stuff that's happening in college football with offenses, that stuff's gone to die at Stanford.
Oh, yeah. Everybody assumed that he was going to be perfect for Graham Harrell's